We hit 20,000 subscribers, and as promised, I'm doing a camera and microphone giveaway, as well as an office tour, because I've been asked to do this multiple times. So if you're interested in winning this camera and microphone, then you're gonna have to watch through the whole video, because there are three steps you're gonna have to do to make sure your name gets entered, and I'm gonna disperse those steps throughout the video, because come on, the least you can do is watch through the whole video. I'm giving away like $800 worth of stuff. So let's start off by looking at the wall here. So, when I first did my setup, I got these things at Hobby Lobby, some little C for my name. This is like a lantern. I don't know why I got that, but it just looked kind of old. We've got this old reel here, just some different photo type stuff. It was all around 100 bucks for all the stuff we got. And oh, look, there's a Canon M50. You see that? With a Rode VideoMic Pro. This is the camera we're gonna be giving away. So, first step, if you would like to win this camera, hit the like button on this video so that I know you're a real person and you do like this video. We have up here a Canon, no, sorry, not Canon, a Sony 85mm 1.4 that I got from my wife, because she shoots pictures a lot more. I don't use that. I usually use my 24-70 most of the time. We have a couple of these RGB, I don't even know the brand, bowling something lights, that's why the background's always different colors. I kind of like this orange now. I did blue all last year and trying to change it up. We've got an old ghetto kit lens that I've talked a lot of smack about this thing, and it's really not good at all, but everyone seems to think they are because zooming always seems better. Got an A7S Mark II here, and we may do another future giveaway with this camera. We'll see how this one goes. But if you come look over here, we have a map of the world that's a scratch-off type thing, and I've scratched off all the places I've been to so far. Still have a lot to go, but I have seen a lot of cool places. So moving around over to here, we have the NTG 4 Plus, I think it is. It's a USB powered, it's pretty nice. We got this ring light here, but as you can see, this is a big room. There's lots of echo. And I'm not putting up a bunch of sound panels in here because I'm probably going to be changing this area up soon. But that's why you hear echo sometimes. It's really not that big a deal. Some people always say, oh, you have echo, your sound's bad. But come on, it's not that bad. It's probably more echoey with this camera mic though. So you can see the difference for sure. Over here, I have a Zoom H5 that the microphone plugs into and I record the audio. This is a Manfrotto MVH500, basically the one that I talk about in my videos for the monopods and the tripods. Now this whole mount here, I got this idea from Caleb from DSLR Video Shooter. I just modified it to using my ring light. He has a big aperture light that goes off of it, but I don't have one of those. And I just run the cable down, plug it up to the wall, have some sandbags down here on the bottom to keep in place. I do push it up against the wall sometimes, but it's just a lot easier to leave it up. As you can see over here, this room is also a schoolroom for our kids because we homeschool them. Over here, I've got this C-stand and this aperture LED here that I use as my hair light. So when I'm standing here, you get some light around the back of you and it just makes everything look better. You stand out from the background a little more. It's kind of rigged up not very well right now. I have another tripod head up there because the mount for that broke when I was traveling and dropped it, but oh well. So moving on, my office is in the closet. I'm like Harry Potter here, covered under the stairs, something like that. So step number two, leave a comment and let me know, where do you do most of your editing? Mine is in the closet. It works out. There's actually quite a bit of space in here. If you come in, we have a MacBook Pro 16 inch here. Behind it, can't really see it, but I have a video on it. It's my external hard drive. It's 14 terabytes, and I'm about to have to get a new one because I'm running out of space. We have this LG widescreen monitor, an iPad, mouse, keyboard. This desk I got from, I don't remember the brand, Jarvis maybe? Or is that, they just make this. It raises up and down. I saw this from one of Chris Howe's videos and I really liked it, as well as this chair. It's pretty comfortable. You can sit in it multiple ways when you're editing, doing all your stuff, so that you're always moving. And a mat down here for when I raise up the desk. I can stand and work, though I don't do that much. If you look over here, one of my favorite books for screenwriting, Save the Cat. I got my main tripod, which I made a video on. I'll have links to all the stuff too if you're interested in any gear that I use. I've made videos on a lot of it. This is pretty new, Peter McKinnon bag. I traded out this bag that I used to use all the time, this Manfrotto one. I wanted some more space when I'm traveling. I kind of wish this was, I had something in between this and that, but I'd rather have a little extra space than not enough. So if you come over here, both of the monopods that I made videos on, I've got my travel tripod that I also made a video on as well. It's Manfrotto. Hopefully it stays. Up there is mostly stuff that I don't use much. They're cases for things, for microphones, drones, all that good stuff. This I wanted for a long time. So we have chargers for everything that are Velcroed down so they don't move. I got these big Sony batteries for things like external monitors and lights for my Sony cameras, Canon cameras, some more Sony. We've got drone batteries, and then of course rechargeables all right here. I've got some hard drives, cables for everything, USB, HDMI. Down here is my live video setup stuff. We've got dummy batteries for the cameras, super long HDMI cables for outdoor use because I do workout videos on my other channel a lot now. If you haven't seen that, link in the description as well. More just power cables. Oh, got this light. I used to use this at weddings a lot. I rarely ever use it now, but it's a spotlight, pretty bright so I can get it far off, usually light up the couple when they're dancing, that type of thing. If you come in here, have some custom made shelving by me, nothing special, but we have the Ronin S gimbal there, an Edelkrone slider, which those are probably gonna be in some future giveaways as well. Mavic Pro, this is the camera I used for the last few years, the A7 III, with a VideoMic Pro Plus on it. This is now my B cam and it's what my wife uses most of the time. It has the, what is this, 16 to 35 millimeter lens on it right now. And this was the other 85 millimeter that my wife used. And the other one out there is a smaller, newer version, and she's trying to see which one she likes better so that we can get rid of one of them. We have multiple Zoom H1s because I used to use these in weddings and put them in people's pockets with lav mics. I use them for myself now too. I always take one on the road. We have a bunch of lens hoods, lens filters. Down here, more lenses, a Sony 55 millimeter, a Canon 50, Nifty 50 with a Sony adapter. Just a kit lens for Canon, nothing special. This is the monitor I use. It's a FuelWorld 4K. It's pretty cheap, but does the trick for the YouTube videos. Got this recently for smartphone. It's pretty nice. I'm starting to do more with my cell phone than I used to. This was our first camera, Canon T2i. Never gonna get rid of that because it's just a reminder of what I started with. And some sound stuff for when I used to sing, but turns out I'm no good at that, so I don't do it anymore. But that is the overall tour. Oh, of course we gotta see this. Have a family picture. Although we're gonna have to update that because we're having a baby. So that's pretty exciting. But the last step for getting entered to win this camera is to go on Instagram. I'll have a link to my Instagram account at CamberFilms. And what you need to do is find the post for this video. It's gonna be the same thumbnail that I have for this video right now. And then leave a comment with your YouTube username. That way I'll know you watched the video and I can verify that you left a comment in this video and I just know it's real people. So I don't have bots and all that kind of stuff to deal with. So we're gonna do that. The giveaway is gonna go all the way through the end of March. So April 1st, giveaway's over. That's not an April Fool's type thing. I am giving this away, but in the beginning of April, first week, once I figure out, verify we got real people and all that stuff, I'll do a drawing, random, and we'll pick someone. So those are the three things you need to do. If you watch the video all the way through, you know. If not, and you're just trying to skip through just to get a free camera, then maybe go back through, watch the whole video so that you'll know what you have to do. And I'm gonna be doing future giveaways too. As I said in my previous live video, every 10,000 subscriber mark, so next will be 30,000 for this year, I'm gonna be doing another giveaway. And if you wanna help that come faster, then all you need to do is subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification, and when a new video comes out, watch it. Because right now we have a whole 0.5% of my subscribers actually watching the new videos when they come out. So if we get more people watching, then that just sends out more good stuff to the algorithm so that it shows more people and we get more subscribers, and then more giveaways and good stuff for you. So like the video, leave comments, all that good stuff, and I will see you in the next one, and good luck.